Good afternoon, Boulder Rotary. We're going to start a few minutes early today because we have a very full agenda and a great program, so we're going to get started just a couple of minutes early. Would Kitty DeKiefer please lead us in the pledge and the four-way test?
Okay. Oh. Thank you. For those of you that can stand, please join me in the Pledge of Allegiance. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. And now please join us in the four-way test. Of the things we think, say, or do, is it the truth? Is it fair to all concerned? Will it build goodwill and better friendships? Will it be beneficial to all concerned? Thank y'all.
Thank you, Kitty. Welcome to Boulder Rotary, the best place to be on a Friday afternoon, whether you're here in the room with us or on Zoom. I know we have close to 25 people on Zoom, roughly. So welcome to everyone on the interwebs as well. Don Wolford, would you please help introduce those of us in the room? And while you're doing that, I've got a question for you. Are we set for any extra food donations? If you could give us an update on that, or if you have any needs, now would be a great time to let the club know if there are any needs for the leftover food.
I brought the trays, so I'm okay. Ready to go.
Perfect.
Visitors? Huh? Want to introduce your visitor?
Yeah. This is my friend and neighbor, Bob Owens. Good friend of mine.
Any other visitors in the room?
There you go. Thank you.
Thanks very much. Richard Jobson here. Yeah, anyway, I'd like to introduce my friend and visitor today, Mark Taylor, and he's from Yorkshire, Kenya, Colorado Springs, and now Massachusetts, Wareham. Thank you.
Alrighty then. Thank you, Don. Really appreciate it. I am going to introduce our guests via Zoom who are joining us via Zoom today. I know that we have Shannon. If you'd like to unmute yourself and say hi.
Hello, Boulder Rotary. Very nice to be here. Looking forward to the program. I visited a few times over the last year and appreciate very much the professional meetings that you have, and thank you for including us on Zoom.
Thank you so much for joining us. I know Dominica is online too.
Yes. Hello, everybody. I'm with you, I think, almost every week now. I look forward to your meetings. I'm past president Dominica of the Rotary Club of Montego Bay in Northwest Jamaica. Lovely to be with you again. Oh, and I see my friend Stephanie just joined us.
Perfect. Thanks so much. And then I know that we have a special guest, Allison. Would you like to say hi?
Hi, thank you.
Thanks for joining us, Allison. If you're not aware, that's Chad's wife. And then I know that we have Jane Westberg, James Dross, Ira Horowitz, Warren, Haley, Jason and Hillard, I think, or Jason. And I believe they're all guests of Gary Karn today. So welcome to everybody.
I'd like to introduce Bob Miller, who is my guest today on Zoom.
Perfect. Thanks so much, everybody, for joining us. I hope you enjoy the meeting.
Thank you, Vanessa. Hi, babe. Nice to see you. A couple of quick announcements. The cookbook, the Boulder Rotary Club Publishing Company, has now released its third book, the Boulder Rotary Pandemic Cookbook. I know you've seen images of this on the rib, and you've seen it in the brew. I'd like to just give a special thanks to Sue Deans, Jancy Campbell, Alan Fields, and to all the contributors to this book. There's a lot of great stuff in there, so be sure to check it out. You can buy it on Amazon. Another quick thing, the Battle of the Books and Destination Imagination, those are the two new programs that we announced last week when Superintendent Anderson was here. Linda Neals and Bob Murphy are coordinating those events respectively. Destination Imagination is going to be on Saturday, March the 5th. Battle of the Books is on April the 30th. In addition, Norris Hermsmeyer is coordinating the club's annual efforts to support the Spelling Bee, which will be on April the 2nd. So please contact those people. They will be contacting you. There's going to be a lot of information forthcoming on these events, but these are three important events that showcase our club's relationship with BVSD. Finally, on your tables, you may have noticed something different today. If you saw Dominica's backdrop in Jamaica, she had a wall full of flags. Well, I want to see the flags back. They make me happy. So Vanessa got them out of the storage closet here at the JCC. We're going to start putting them back on the tables because the banners represent a really cool part of Rotary. And I know we have some red badgers here who don't quite maybe know or understand what they represent or the possibilities that they provide. This is our club's banner. And what happens when you travel abroad or if you travel to another club, even in our own district, you can take one of our club's banners, you can do an exchange with somebody at the club you're visiting, bring it back to us, talk to us about the experience. We'll give you a couple minutes up here. There are several on the table that I know that I personally have brought back from places overseas. The one right here on the table, which Marty placed appropriately today, is from the Rotary Club of Jerusalem. So when you go to these places, go visit another club. It's such a wonderful experience. That's all I have for the announcements. Now I'd like to have Bill Anderson put on his earmuffs while everyone else takes out your raffle tickets. And while we're doing that, the raffle's coming up. If Cassidy Murphy would come up here and provide us with a quick election. All right, 724-904. 724-904, Mr. Weatherwax. Yep. And here's Cassidy with today's nominees and the election.
All right. I have been asked by Lena and Janet who the people who are stepping off the board are in July, and I don't know. My brain just did a total... Valerie, going to be stepping off the board. My brain just did a total stop on that. So perhaps we can collectively get that information to Lena and Janet, and we will have a better decision. You will find on your tables there are blue slips. Those are your ballots for the board and for the president-elect nominee, which is Carl Kurtz. We are picking four people today to go onto the board. It's an eight-person member-at-large board. Four people stay on, four people move off. This will start in July. Please fill out one if you are a Boulder Rotary member. Please do not fill out one if you're a guest. If you'd like to fill out one next year, become a member. Online, we're going to have people fill out a Google form that's anonymous. I will be putting the link in the chat as soon as I'm off the stage. And Michael Brady and Michael Weatherwax will be collecting, the ballots from you. We will have a decision for you before the meeting's ended. The people who are leaving the board, we have some confirmation will be Valerie, Carl, Kurtz, Chris Coker, and Kitty DeKiefer. All right. Any further?
Susan.
It's Susan here, not Kitty.
Oh, Susan, not Kitty. Sorry.
Both of them.
Oh.
We're missing somebody then.
Well, this is wrong then. No.
Bill Anderson, can you please come up and introduce a new member?
So this only goes to show you how much I'm going to miss Susan Connolly when she's not co-chair of the Red Badge Committee. Quickly on that note, before I introduce our newest member, Kat Stinson, we are in need of leadership support on the Red Badge Committee. If anyone is interested in participating, please reach out to me in person, email, text message, however you like. Okay. So please welcome our club's newest member, Kat Stinson, who is sponsored by Gene Lindeke and Marty Evans. Kat moved to Colorado 2.5 years ago. As part of planting new roots here in Colorado, she's excited to join our club, to meet new people, deepen her connections with the community, and give back. Originally from Lafayette, California, just outside of San Francisco and close to Yosemite. Kat was last living on the East Coast. She attended college and law school in Vermont and spent time working in Boston and Providence, Rhode Island. She missed the great outdoors, and that is what sparked her interest in moving to Boulder. Kat found a job at FNBO, First National Bank of Omaha, here in Boulder. Starting at FNBO as the Director of Trust Services for the Southern Market, she recently transitioned roles internally to Senior Financial Advisor. The new role expands her work with clients while still focusing on trust and estate planning, financial planning, and investments. When not working at the bank, Kat's number one job right now is wedding planning. She's getting married in April. Congratulations. Since she and her future husband both love to ski, they are getting married in the Sierras in California so they can ski before the wedding. Kat loves to cook, especially for other people. Bringing people together through food is one of her passions. Yummy. The most adventurous thing Kat has done is to travel alone backpacking in Europe. In law school, she took an unusual step for a law student by studying abroad. She studied comparative constitutional law in Italy, near the great skiing in the Dolomites. Kat's fiance is a firefighter in Aurora. Together they enjoy long walks with their new home from their new home in Loveland with their big chocolate lab named appropriately Chip, like chocolate chip. In any event, please welcome Kat Stinson.
Congratulations, Kat.
Dr. George Russell, can we please turn to birthdays?
Yes, we'd like people to sit at the birthday
table. We have, I always try to make sure that everyone gets noticed on their birthday. I try to do it with a little humor. With humor, you have to learn to say something that is uncommon. You have to be able to know your audience. I know my audience, and that's why I repeat several jokes, because you can't remember them. One is this poem. Some people call them the golden years, but they don't seem golden to me. It's hard to stand up and I can't bend over, and it's getting harder to see. Some people call them the wonder years, and to me that's what they are, because I walked out of McGuckin's last week and wondered where I parked my car. I'm using more four-letter words now than I ever used before. Words like pain and what and when, and I'm using them more and more. Five fingers of Irish whiskey used to make me feel so fine. Now it seems about half as much can butter and clutter my mind. But as each birthday comes to pass, I always gladly lift a glass and toast to your health and may it last. And these golden years can kiss my, well, whatever. We have one birthday boy today, Brad Weasley.
Thank you all. I know time's short, so I'll be quick. I resemble that remark, by the way, or that poem, George. I'm not real big on birthdays, so I sit at the table about once every 7 years, much to George's frustration. So I'll see you again in a few years. It's a great part to be part of this club.
Happy birthday.
Happy birthday, Brad, and thanks for all your work as the treasurer of our club. I know that it for me, it's amazing all the work that you do, and I appreciate it. So thank you and happy birthday. Fred, can we roll the brew, please?
This week, we thought we'd take a minute to highlight your newsletter, the Rotary in Boulder, the RIB. Now, your first question is, when does it come out? The answer is, it comes out on Tuesday, unless it comes out on Wednesday. And if it's not out on Tuesday or Wednesday, then it comes out on Thursday. Maybe. In the corporate world, that's called missing a deadline. In the nonprofit world, that's called a special edition, special Wednesday and special Thursday. They're wonderful. So the very beginning of your newsletter is what the program is for the Friday. So this situation, we have Rob Anderson. Hi, Rob. As we go down, we have the link to join the meeting right there. If you're wondering where it is, it's in your newsletter that is in your inbox, Tuesday, Wednesday, or Thursday. Then you can reserve your meal for the next Rotary meeting, all the upcoming events right there, and committee briefs. Of course, you got to get that cookbook. Good stuff. As we go down, we have membership brief, like birthdays right here, and new member proposal. You can read all about the person who is about to join your club. Then we have the program link, great summary. From the summary, you can also click to watch the actual program, and then the click the non-program. Takes you right to YouTube, where Boulder Rotary has a YouTube channel. But right down here, I think is really interesting. See this sub? That is for sub knitting club announcements. Get it? Then this little microphone, that's for program ideas. Not quite as funny as the sub, but still very, very important. So that is your newsletter. Let's hope that you open up next week's and really pay attention to it, because it's got lots of good information in it. Thank you to Chad and to Cassidy and Bill Meyer and all the people who helped put it together. I know I'm forgetting somebody. Today we have two new characters in our cast of hand puppets for the announcements. Let me give you the background on the first one. He is a vice president of a local hospital and laughs at his own jokes. He's a villain. His name is Errol Frown. The second character, she's really sweet, but she's married to this guy. Her name is Sally, S-A-L-L-I-E, Frown. Errol and Sally Frown. So you remind me an awful lot of one of the members in the Boulder Rotary Club, but your mustache looks a lot nicer. Anyway, when I was president, there were these two members who were in charge of the brew, and they would make fun of me as the president all the time. And I don't think that's not really nice. That hurt my feelings. So I'm going to be really nice and not make fun of you, Errol, in particular. What's that? You'd rather I do make fun and make some jokes at a member's expense? What's his name? Daryl, not Errol. Daryl, you want me to make fun of Daryl Brown? Okay, that's what I'll do. So, we have an announcement, don't we? Sally, I know that one of the members in the club named Sally is in charge of a dinner May 6th. It is a fundraiser. Members of the community will be invited, and it will be a great time. So what we need people to do right now is pull out their phone, piece of paper, write down May 6th. It's a Friday. Everyone in the club should come. It will be a great event from Boulder Rotary Club and Boulder Rotary Club Foundation. Looking forward to spending more time with Errol and Sally Frown.
Hopefully by now, everyone has heard about the great work the World Community Service Committee has done at the Pine Ridge Reservation in South Dakota with the house-to-house clean water connection project. The champions of that project, Alessandra Sachs and Lynn Johnson, have done an analysis of how effective that work is. You can find links to that in this week's RIB, and we will have it again in next week's RIB. Safe drinking water on the Pine Ridge Reservation has been a long-term concern. The groundwater there has arsenic and uranium. The federal government funded a project to get clean water to the Pine Ridge Reservation, but it does not fund the connections that get the clean water to each individual home. Boulder Rotary and 22 other Rotary clubs are working to fund those connections. As part of the analysis that Alessandro and Lynn did, they found that every dollar donated is worth about $3.60 for safe drinking water. That's an amazing return on the money. There are details and links in the RIB. Don't miss it. February is Black History Month. In honor of that, the first program on February 4th will be Adrian Miller, the director of the Colorado Council of Churches. He will be speaking on the history of Black people in Colorado. Adrian Miller is a Colorado native. He was deputy director of the first White House initiative to look at opportunity gaps that exist for minorities in the U.S. That was the One America initiative. He's been an advisor to Governor Bill Ritter, and he is an author of two books, the first being Soul Food, The Surprising Story of an American Cuisine, and President's Kitchen Cabinet, The Story of African Americans Who Have Fed Our First Families from the Washingtons to the Obamas. We hope you'll be there for the February 4th program.
All together now.
Have a great weekend.
won the James Beard Award. For those of you that don't know, that's the Oscars of food, so that is a very big deal. I would like to announce the winners of the election. Congratulations to new board members Linda Davidson, Norma Portnoy, Mike Simpson, and Hans Wick. Thanks to all of those for putting their names in. This is such a great slate of candidates. And also congratulations to Carl Kurtz, who won unopposed today. Pat Simons will stay on to answer additional questions on Zoom. She's on right now, so thank you, Pat. Thank you, Mike Brady and Kat Stenson, for greeting us at the door. Thanks, Jerry Walsh and Jim Ross for checking us in at the desk. Thanks, Carl, for promoting the raffle. Thanks to the tandem of Mike and Mike, Weatherwax and Brady, for proctoring the election today. And thanks to meeting management, Fred, Cassidy, Vanessa, and Lynn. Meeting adjourned.